guys, Caleb here, back again with more bad fanfiction theater, and I have guests.
So will we. Or Norm.
I have Norman Musies. Musies. You're a musical Musies. So how are you guys today?
Okay.
I'm doing all right.
So today, we will be reading a story called Link Goes to Hogwarts by Nonbindo. I think I'm saying that right. And this was a request. Let me scroll over so I can actually view the name. By John Tro. I hope I'm saying that right as well. Over on Patreon. So if you want to follow along, there will be a link down in the description below. I assume most of us are roughly familiar with Legend of Zelda and Harry Potter, yes?
Yes.
Sure.
Okay. So, Norm, whenever you are ready, we are reading by chapter.
Okay. Chapter 1. Link was riding in the interdimensional spacer time bus with the four-legged mutant bus driver. The four-legged mutant bus driver was like, time to go to Hogwarts. So Link got off the bus and walked into Hogwarts. And then Dumbledore said, I apologize for the rudeness of this question, but who the flying fuckity fuck might you be, young
one? This is like Dumbledore saying, what the hell are you doing, motherfuckers? Am I immortal? It's great. Also, a mutant bus driver, why are they taking a school bus to Hogwarts? Don't they take a train? I mean, I guess since he's going from his reality to this Hogwarts one. Continue.
I am Link, and this is my fairy friend, Navy. pointing to the aforementioned fairy.
He's in the Navy! Run away!
Hi, I'm Navy, said Navi. Well then, a jolly good pleasure to meet both of you.
He's got a giant club of ham,
said Dumbledore Britishly.
I hope so, since he's, you know, from England.
Because he's from Britishland. Oh, it's an island in Asia. British.
Okay, so I'm pretty sure England isn't in Asia somewhere, but you know what? Let's pretend it is.
Is it part of which Asian island is it? China?
Is well, it China's not necessarily an island.
Hong Kong. Is it South Korea, North Korea, Japan, Taiwan, Singapore?
They meant Hawaii. They just wasn't sure exactly where Asia was.
Oh, I see.
Link, you must be a wizard. A wizard. Because the muggy killing charms didn't send you flying into Hogwarts toilet.
Okay, hold on. Okay, so apparently Link is a guard of peeing. I guess he protects you while you go to the bathroom. Like, he keeps, you know, watch or something. Also, I don't think Hogwarts... Maybe I'm wrong, because granted, I haven't really read the books. I only read, like, one book, and that was the sixth book. But I'm pretty sure Hogwarts itself doesn't have a muggle repelling charm, nor would they send somebody into a toilet inside the school if it's meant to repel them from the school.
The only scene I remember in the movies that had a toilet, I think it was part of the Ministry of Magic, I think they used the toilet.
Well, there was also a Moaning Myrtle who died in the toilet.
What's a Hogwarts toilet? Link asked wisely.
That's not wisely. That's not wise at all. He doesn't know.
A Hogwarts toilet is a bloody toilet found at the geographical location of Hogwarts, of course.
It's a bloody toilet? Did somebody menstruate in that? Actually, if they're farting in it, it's probably bloody farts. They should get that looked at.
No. Would you be joining the bloody school? Asked Dumbledore with a British accent.
We don't need to know it's a British accent. We know he's British because it takes place over there.
Okay.
I mean, they said it took place in British land, so obviously he'd have a British accent.
Yeah, it's in the British land on an island in Asia. Sire, why not?
Dumbledore's not a king or a lord, the last I knew.
The interdimensional four-legged mutant bus driver said it was time to go to Hogwarts, so I probably should. The four-legged mutant bus driver has never steered. Live on, get it? Because he drives a bus and therefore steers a wheel.
That's not really clever.
Didn't make sense, but...
Yeah, I'm like, that's not really clever. Doesn't make sense again, because why is there a bus driver mutant dude taking you to Hogwarts? Also, why is your enrollment here in question if they are specifically taking you to Hogwarts to study here? That means you are a wizard of some kind, in theory. I mean, Dumbledore should already know this. He doesn't need to ask.
Somebody help me wrong before. Link replied in even more... telling this, it sounds like he lost some intelligence points or something.
he got intellect devoured by an intellect devourer. He just lost some smarts.
The amount of times he hit the chickens, I think the chickens got them.
Yeah, and the chickens got pissed and just started pecking them in the head, taking out brain matter. I mean, they do kick your ass, from what I remember.
Excellent. But you jolly well need some bloody money to buy your school things, British Dumbledore.
You know, that's actually a good question that they probably covered in the books, but I don't actually know. How do Muggleborn buy their stuff? Do they get, like, an allotment from the, like, an allowance from school? Because wizarding money is not the same thing as muggle money. So the pounds would have to be converted into... Ah, crap, I don't remember. Is it galleons that they call it? I don't remember now. But it would have to, like, some sort of conversion there.
I have money. I have rupees, said Link, holding up a green rupee.
That's
true. Isn't that an Indian currency?
No, well, yes, but also in the Legend of Zelda games, that's the currency of money, is a rupee.
So I looked up the wizarding money. So it comes in bronze knots, silver sickles, and golden galleons. There are 29 knots in one sickle and 17 sickles make up a galleon. The end.
Okay. I mean, that still doesn't really answer my question for, like, what do muggle-raised children do in that case when they go to Hogwarts? Like, how do they get by their stuff? Because, again, I don't think you could spend your muggle money in wizarding anywhere. I don't think.
So, apparently, this is from Reddit. So, how do muggle-borns pay for Hogwarts stuff and everything? They can exchange muggle money for wizard money in Gringotts. In the COS, they meet Hermione and her parents in front of Gringotts. So presumably they have some exchange method set up for this.
Okay. I mean, I would assume they'd have to do something, because otherwise she couldn't go to school because she wouldn't have any way to purchase anything.
You can sell her clothes. I don't know.
I mean, you could, but I don't, except for Ron's dad, I don't know who else would be interested in exchanging money for your personal items.
Said Dumbledore, opening a magazine in a British manner.
So what, he's like sitting in a chair, you know, all Minecraft and Sherlock Holmes, and just opens a book and starts reading and not really giving a shit what happens to you? Is that what you mean as a British manner? That doesn't really describe anything he's doing, except that it's Britishly.
I didn't get it at that time. Accordion to fictional currencies monthly. 1 rupee is worth 110 billion galleons. So you probably have enough.
I'm pretty sure that's not really how trading works, but, I mean, inflation must be, like, crazy over there. Makes me think of that book I read, I can't remember what it's called now. But basically it was, an American girl pen-palling a, I think it was a boy in Zimbabwe? It might have been a different location, that my memory is a little foggy. but it was like in the 90s, so during a time when his country was like in lots of turmoil and money was like very hard to get and people were very underhanded because you needed money to get things like food and all that. She sent him a dollar. And him and his mother went to, like, their local bank to exchange it. And he got, like, 24 Zimbabwe dollars out of that. And that was enough to buy, like, I think rice, beans, and chicken. Because before, they had only been eating, I think, some, like, beans and a little bit of bread. If they could manage the bread.
Awesome spectacular. Said Link happily. Indeed so. Now, will you need bloody assistance in...
Diagon Alley. It's supposed to be Diagon Alley. But diagonally, I mean, that could be diagonally. Also, just because your Britishly character is saying bloody in every sentence doesn't make him even more Britishly. It just makes you sound incredibly uneducated. They talk like normal people, they just have a different way of speech. Like, until I started watching Sherlock, I didn't know that you could just say, would you like a cuppa? And leave it at that, because as an American, I'm sitting there like, a cup of what? A cup of tea? A cup of coffee? A cup of Coke? What the fuck are you asking me? Apparently that just means, like, tea, I guess.
I wonder if you can drink tea out of a teacup and still think it's tea.
Well, if you're drinking tea out of a teacup, I'm pretty sure it's tea.
What happens if it was Coca-Cola?
Then you're drinking Coke out of a teacup.
Wait, would that be considered tea?
No, because it's Coke.
Oh.
It's like me drinking anything but White Lightning out of a mason jar.
I may have to reread this line because I didn't know this was Dumbledore.
Oh, that's okay.
You spelled it wrong. Look at the way he spells it. Okay. Indeed so. Now, will you need bloody assistance in diagonally? Ask.
Dumbledore became Russian. Oh, I kind of want that now. Alternate universe Dumbledore. Instead of being an Englishman, he's going to be like this Russian dude. That would be cool.
No thanks. Just directions should be fine. Replied Link. I've never gotten lost before, but even if I did, one of Navi's fairy powers is to know everything.
I don't think that's how Navi works.
Hey, listen.
Hey, listen, you fucktard. I gotta tell you something important that you don't really care about, but I gotta tell you anyway, because the game says I should.
So Navi's the equivalent of the owl in King's Quest.
Woohoo!
Sure bloody thing, he replied Dumbledore while explaining the directions for how to get to
Diagon Alley
Britishly.
So he
Diagon Alley Britishly.
Okay, so he replied, So he just said it twice for some reason.
Okay. Okay, thanks, said Link while playing the
Ocarina
and dancing a Kokiri.
Kokiri.
Kokiri. Jig. And walking off. Was this in the game?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. And walking off towards diagonally while riding his unicycle and juggling fish.
I don't think those last two were, though.
His last two words?
The last two things. Like the ocarina and the Kokiri, though I'm not sure about Kokiri Jig, were in the games. A unicycle, wherever he pulled that out from, and juggling fish, wherever he also pulled those out from, were not.
It's really funny the way you try to pronounce Kokiri. I thought he was saying cockery.
It's a big cock!
Oh no, I was thinking of cuck holding.
Link went forth happily riding his unicycle into shots, who clapped at his impressive unicycling skills. Since he could ride it on as fast as a normal person could ride a bicycle, except a billion times faster and with incredibly precise precision.
He could ride it normally, but he could also do it a billion times faster with better precision. Also, wouldn't his first stop be Gringotts? So he could, you know, exchange that rupee for the money that would be accepted in town? At these stores.
But some wizards and or witches were angry at the
Muggle.
Contraption. And tried to have it
If they did this in plain sight, they would be immediately arrested by authorities. You don't ever do the killing curse. Also, you don't just say abracadabra and not explain that it is one of the forbidden spells that literally will kill somebody in an instant and can't be reversed, from what I recall.
Okay. That was in the movies?
That was in the books. That's how Harry's parents died. That's how Voldemort cured Harry's parents, yes?
There's a way to reverse it.
There is?
Reverse the polarity of the neutron flow.
I don't get it.
Oh, it's Doctor Who.
Oh, I don't watch Doctor Who.
So Link played the song of time to open a time hole and pull the master sword out of the time hole, which he then used to deflect the abracadabra beams back at the evil wizards who tried to kill him.
Okay.
Killing them instantly.
Sure.
Right. Some...
Horrors
came to arrest Link, but some people pointed out that they were evil dead wizards who tried to abracadabra Link, which was good because it meant Link didn't have to deflect their subduing spells until they collapsed of exhaustion.
Wait, what? I'm really confused by this last sentence. Killing them instantly, some horrors came to arrest Link. Some people pointed out that they were evil wizards who had tried to use the killing curse on Link, which was good because it meant Link didn't have to deflect their subduing spells. Okay, I see what we're trying to say, but it was so thrown together in a run-on sentence that I didn't really understand. So I think what the sentence is trying to say is Link is happy that they went straight for a killing curse because he really would like not to have been bothered to deflect all the other spells they could have been throwing at him until he deflected so much that they basically just passed out from magical exhaustion because he's that good, I guess, at dodging.
Link spent the entire day buying a bunch of stuff and bought a lot of stuff. He converted two of his rupees into galleons at Gringotts, so he had 22 billion galleons and spent 50.
Wait, he spent so he just 50 or he spent 50. Or he spent 20 billion of those gallons he had.
Well, he certainly didn't specify that. So he put the other 775
billions, trillions, and then zillions.
Zillions. What comes after a zillion?
Quadrillion.
And then after quadrillion?
I'm gonna go with infinity.
I was gonna say a jillion, I guess. I don't know. But that's a lot of shit. So if you just want to say the numbers, because I don't even know how you would begin to read that aloud. You can do it.
775 quadrillion 999
fuck ton.
I'm lost. Okay, it's 775, 999, 654, 128, 526, 228, 214, 864 galleons in his infinity wallet that he got from the ultimate great fairy that lives on the four-legged mutant bus, driver's four-legged mutant bus.
The bus also has four legs and people live on it? Did they convert it into a tiny house? How is it still... Well, I guess it could still be movable. Depending on how you made the tiny house.
It was able to hold infinite money.
Okay, apparently we channeled our inner Kingdom Hearts. You know, that would be a good way to do this, I guess. If you really wanted to, you could just sort of, like, in a minor way, squeeze in a little Kingdom Hearts jargon. So instead of a bus, he would have arrived on a gummy ship that he just hitched a ride on. And it would also make sense because the gummy ships can go from one world to the next. As long as you plow through all the heartless that are in your way. And then, of course, he has all this money, which is the currency in Kingdom Hearts. Literally spelled like that.
That's why it's the infinite wallet.
No shit, Sherlock.
Then Link went and bought books. And potions crap. And a wand that was made of the ancient burning phoenix of the sun. And the wood of an ebony tree. Link went to sleep at the inn for 7 weeks.
Oh my god. And
it was time to head back to Hogwarts to get sorted.
Why would he be that early for school when if he had 7 weeks left, he could have just went and done something else. And then came back like a few days before school started to get his stuff. He didn't.
Yeah, he could have done a lot of stuff in 7 weeks.
Yeah, but apparently he just took the world's most epic nap. That's at least 2 months.
Yeah, it sounds like all he did was eat and sleep.
Well, maybe that's what Link does in secret when he's not adventuring.
Yeah. Students were supposed to go on the Warthog train, but Link was no mood for such idiotic fiddle-faddery.
But you're already there! Why would you need to take the train? Plus, you have a motherfucking... How was you speaking to Dumbledore if he wasn't already there?
So he simply waited until the last second before...
McGonagall
called his name to be sorted and leapt into the air with lightning fast speed all the way to above Hogwarts and crashed through the roof. Then he used the glider to gently float down into the sorting chair for McGonagall to place the sorting hat upon his head.
And nobody's gonna bitch about how you just crashed into the dining room of Hogwarts? How did you get past the wards if you didn't come with the rest of the school kids? How did you get in there? Well, I guess you were on a bus that was taking you specifically to Hogwarts, so Dumbledore would have known that you were coming and let you pass through the wards. I'm confused, because you shouldn't be able to do that at all.
He said... leapt into the air, so I don't know, go through the roof or something.
Well, the way I saw it, he like teleported into the sky, crashed through the roof, And then after he broke through the roof, he used a hang glider or whatever and just floated gently to the ground. Everybody's food is ruined now because they're covered in, like, ceiling dust and debris.
Gryffindor, said the Sorting Hat. Cool, said Link. Detention, said McGonagall. Nah, said Link. McDonald demanded. Link is kind of above any sort of restrictions on anything. They're his antithesis. For he comes to free those bold enough to follow his path to the end of all reason, said Navi wisely.
I'm pretty sure that the answer to that is no. Also, you're not going to tell McGonagall, nah. She's going to immediately spell your ass, and you're probably going to get even more detention after that.
Link nodded helpfully. Well then, he's quite free to leave.
No, he's not! No, McGonagall would not allow that.
McGonagall sternly said.
McGonagall.
Wasn't it? Oh, never mind.
He keeps changing it, so.
It's hard to follow. McGonagall sternly said, for though she wasn't evil, her heart was full of chains and horribleness.
Because she's a bitter person. McGonagall never struck me as bitter or anything like that. I mean, she's had a lot of, like, stuff that has happened in her life that sucks, but I mean, who hasn't?
Nope, I'm staying. I'm bound to no law and travel where I wish. Such is the nature of the truest soul, exclaimed Link with such virtue that the chains around McGonagall's change it again. McGonagall's heart began to slowly crack, and she fainted from the newfound freedom and had to be winged to a hospital.
Okay. So apparently Link is saying all this, including what happened to McGonagall, because it does the quotations end at the end of this sentence. Also, I don't think she was meaning leave the building. I think she just meant he can leave and do what he wants. But apparently Link is like, nope, I can do whatever the fuck I want, so I'm staying here. And I'm like, well, you're not really traveling wherever you want to go. You're just kind of existing here because you think I told you to go away. Also, how would any of this bullshit free McGonagall's heart? Whatever name you want to give her. Link, so far, is just an asshole. There's been no character building moment between these two, with the exception of him being an asshole. My brain hurts.
I like the part where it says she fainted from the newfound freedom and had to be winged with a hospital.
Yeah, I don't know if any. I mean, they probably will levitate your body, but I don't know about flying you there. Also, to the hospital wing or to, like, an actual physical hospital?
I don't know, but it said winged with a hospital.
I was thinking she was just transported there, winged, to the hospital.
Imagine, like, a hospital lifting the car.
Like, there's, like, all kinds of winged creatures running around, just moving you into different places.
No, it'll be, like, the physical building.
Oh, the building itself has wings?
Yeah. Meanwhile, the students were escorted to their common rooms, and Link said a boy with a lightning scar off his forehead.
Uh-huh.
So Link introduced himself. Hello, my name is Link, and this is my farty Navi. Hi, I'm Perry Hodder. Nice to meet you.
I like where it says.
What?
I can't breathe. It's killing me.
No, we must save Muse. Don't look at the story, Muse. Don't look at the story.
And this is my farty.
Maybe that's why the toilets were full of blood, because Nabby is the bad bloody fairy.
My lungs hurt.
Harry shook Link's foot.
He shook his foot?
Yes, what's it? Harry shook Link's foot.
Okay.
And then they went to bed sleep. I'm thinking of making more chapters of this because going to bed sleep is no way to end the story. I think I should go to end book one and at least where Link will kill Voldemort for good.
So just to point out before we go to the next chapter, I like this sentence. And Link said, "A boy with a lightning scar off his forehead." What did he say about him? And how did the scar come off his forehead? And that's just a whole lot of nothing happened.